Our first unit is National Income. In this unit, we will study introduction, definition, concept and measurement of national income. Circular flow of national income is also an important topic. Then we will study the obstacles which we have to face in the accurate calculation of GNP. What is national income? National income is defined as the total value of all the goods and services produced by a country measured in terms of money. گویا نیشنل انکم یا قومی آمدنی کسی ملک میں ایک سال کے عرصے میں پیدا ہونے والی ایسی اشیاء خدمات ہیں. What is national income? National income is defined as the total annual value of all the goods and services produced by a country measured in terms of money. گویا نیشنل انکم किसी मुल्क में एक साल के अरसे में पैदा होने वाले गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज की मॉनेटरी वैल्यू के बराबर होती है. इनफैक्ट द कंसेप्ट ऑफ नेशनल इनकम इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नेशनल इनकम डाटा इज वेरी वैल्यूएबल बिकॉज इट प्रोवाइड्स अस अ समरी स्टेटमेंट ऑफ आवर कंट्रीज एग्रीगेट इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज. इट हेल्प्स अस इन मेनी वेज. It helps us to measure the size of the economy. It also helps us to measure the health of the economy. And no doubt, it also helps us to understand how an economy functions. Here are some definitions of national income described by different economists. According to Marshall, the labor and capital of a country acting on its natural resources produce annually a certain net aggregate of commodities, material and immaterial, including services of all kinds. This is the true net annual income or revenue of the country. So, according to Marshall, aggregate of goods and services produced by four factors of production in a country within a year is national income. According to Pigou, national income consists of such goods and services which can be measured and valued in terms of money. In fact, Pigou includes only those goods and services which have monetary value. J.M. Keynes defined national income in a different way. According to him, national income takes different forms. At one side, national income is the aggregate output of goods and services, and on the other hand, national income is the aggregate expenditures on goods and services, and it also takes the form of aggregate income of all factors of production. In this lecture, we will discuss some concepts of national income: gross national product GNP, gross domestic product GDP, net national product NNP, national income NI, personal income and disposable personal income. The first concept is gross national product GNP. Gross national product is the total market value of all final goods and services produced in a year. GNP includes net factor income from abroad. It means GNP includes income not only produced within the country but also foreign income. The equation of GNP is equal to C plus I plus G plus NX, where C represents the consumption of private sector, I represents the investment of private sector, while the G represents the government expenditures on consumption and investment of government sector. Here the NX represents the net exports, which means the difference between exports and imports. Here two things must be noted regarding this definition of GNP. Only currently produced goods and services must be included in the GNP. And the double counting should be avoided. These two points will be discussed in detail in the next lecture. The second important concept is gross domestic product, GDP. Gross domestic product is the total market value of all final goods and services currently produced within the domestic territory of a country in a year by nationals or non-nationals. So, if we subtract net factor income from abroad from GNP, we obtained gross domestic product. The equation of the GDP, GDP is equal to GNP minus FI. FI here represents the foreign income. So, if we subtract the foreign income from GNP, we get GDP. The next concept is net national product, NNP. NNP is the market value of all final goods and services after providing for depreciation. Because market value of final goods and services is gross product, not the net one. So, when charges for depreciation are deducted from the GNP, we get NNP. The equation of NNP, NNP is equal to GNP minus depreciation. Depreciation is the consumption of fixed capital or fall in the value of fixed capital due to VRR TL. Here the question is, why does machinery depreciate? Three factors matters in this connection. First one, continuous use of machinery. Number two, no use of machinery. Another factor is the new technology. Because when new technology invents, the old technology automatically depreciates. The next concept is national income. National income means the total income earned by the whole nation. As all the people works as factors of production, so national income is the sum of wages, rent, interest rate and profits paid to the factors for their contribution to the production of goods and services in a year. Here is the equation of national income. We calculate national income from net national product, NNP. As NNP shows market value of final goods and services, so it depends on market prices. In market prices, taxes are added and subsidies are subtracted. So in order to calculate national income from NNP, we subtract indirect taxes and added subsidies as the equation shows. Here NI, national income, is equal to NNP, and we subtract indirect taxes from the net national product and add the subsidies. Here the next concept is personal income. Personal income is the sum of all incomes actually received by all individuals or households during a given year. In national income, there are some income which is earned but not actually received by the households, such as social security contributions, corporate income taxes, and undistributed profits. On the other hand, there are income which is also known as transfer payment, which is received but not actually earned, such as old age pensions, unemployment allowances, relief payments. Thus, in moving from national income to personal income, we must subtract the incomes earned but not received and add incomes received but not currently earned. So the equation of the personal income is equal to national income plus R minus PT minus UP. Here national income, here NI represents the national income, where R represents the transfer payment which must be added in the national income, while the two factors must be deducted from the national income in order to calculate the personal income. And these two factors are profit tax and undistributed corporate profits. Next concept is disposable personal income. In fact, a person is not free to consume all his personal income where he wants. First of all, he has to make some necessary payments such as direct taxes. From personal income, if we deduct personal taxes like income tax, personal property tax, what remains is called disposable income. So the equation of the disposable personal income, DPI, is equal to personal income minus PT. Here PT represents the personal taxes. As all the disposable personal income can either be consumed or saved, so the DPI is equal to C plus S. Here C represents the consumption and S represents the saving.